Greetings, LGR here, or at least my hand and my voice. And let's go ahead and just dive right into this because I am amazed at some of this stuff that I have gotten here to show you today. I've opened one of these boxes already, but there's a whole entire other one right here that I have not opened yet. And we're just going to go ahead and get right to it because this is some pretty special, pretty rare stuff, some of it all for the IBM PC. So either DOS games or PC booters, some early Windows things maybe, but I think it's all DOS and PC booter stuff. This all comes from one generous viewer of mine going by Jackson. Thank you so much yet again. He sent me all of this stuff. Apparently it belonged to his father back in the day, and it was just hanging around for decades, and he was just going through it. And it's just like, you know what? I don't know anywhere else. It's just going to go to you if you want it. And I'm like, yeah, dude. So he sent me a huge list, massive list of stuff. And I picked all the things that were interesting to me and that I didn't already have, such as Might and Magic 3, Isles of Terra by New World Computing. I have a lot of the other Might and Magic things, but I did not have this one until now. So that's awesome. This one isn't particularly rare, but it is super cool because it comes with a whole bunch of like really awesome stuff. Tons of discs. I mean, big old manual. Yeah. I probably won't be showing the insides of a lot of these unless it's just particularly really interesting. So, yeah, anyway. So let's just kind of go on here because this is really going to be a ramble. And I'm trying to do this as quickly as I can, but I just want to spend forever looking at all these. I mean, look at this game. Dungeon. I love the way that's spelled. I love this like 16-year-old like high schooler art. The sticker that says MicroStation. And it's by a company called Screenplay. Which is fascinating because apparently they were based in Chapel Hill, North Carolina, which is not far from where I grew up. In fact, I spent time in Chapel Hill for a while just for various things. And yeah, I mean, there's some, you know, some of this stuff, like I said, is really rare. This one I had never even heard of. In fact, there's several things in here that I had never heard of, such as this here. It's an SSI game called Shard of Spring. And they did, of course, most famously, probably to this audience, the Gold Box series of Dungeons & Dragons, AD&D stuff. But then there's this one. I had never heard of it, so I thought that was pretty cool to have. And this is, awesome. IBM PC. This one's kind of beat up here, but it's one that I was wanting nonetheless. This is Genghis Khan by Koei. And, pretty sweet, actually. These games are really fascinating. I've covered Liberty or Death before, which is somewhat similar to the Genghis Khan series, sort of. But, even though it's not in the best shape, I'm still happy to have some version of this. Same goes for this game right here. This is called The Phantom's Revenge. Now, I tweeted and put this on my Facebook, and within a day of posting it, I already had four people saying, dude, I will pay you, like, whatever, if you're selling this. Because apparently this is really rare. In fact, I couldn't even find any pictures of this box online before now. It's just, an interactive fiction kind of text adventure thing, but it's from 1982, I believe. I haven't even opened it yet. It's a little torn up here, but just by the fact that so many people have already asked me to, like, buy it, I figure it's something kind of special. I don't know. I am going to be trying to back these up on, for my own archives, which I always do with my stuff. But none of this is for sale because, I mean, this was, it was generated, generously donated to me by Jackson, so I don't really want to sell it. I would rather cover these at some point in the future. Like this right here, Spellbreaker. It's the third in the Enchanter series by Infocom, of course. And this is their kind of boxes that were more popular, I suppose. They have like the cool, usually like feelies would go in there. It was like the little pin and stuff. And there's the sort of booklet at the beginning. So these are the more common Infocom boxes. Some of these even are kind of uncommon, but this one in particular I don't think is too much. Now, some of these others, though, holy crap, look at this. So here is Enchanter by Infocom, and this, I want to be really careful with it because it does actually, it's kind of fragile. But so this all comes apart into this really extravagant kind of artistic looking piece. It's just, it's great. These big giant folio sleeves here by Infocom. These are their, I think, the really earliest ones that were on the IBM PC. So yeah, pretty special to have gotten this in such good shape. As well as this right here, we've got Sorcerer, which is the second in the Enchanter series. And it has that sort of mirror there. Oh, hello. I like that a lot. That's so cool to me. So I've got the Enchanter trilogy here. I'm not sure if there was any more beyond that, but I at least have the trilogy now. And check this out. Here's another folio release of Infocom Planetfall right here. And again, early release. And this game is awesome. By the way, I've always liked this game. There's a bunch of cool stuff just sort of packed all throughout here. This is one that I would love to cover sometime. Although I struggle because, you know, text adventures, how do you really show them in a video without them being kind of boring? I'll figure out a way. Because I got to talk about these somehow. They're just too legendary not to, basically. The Magic Candle. Now, this is a series that I have never played. I have, I think, the Magic Candle 3 as well. But, yeah, you know, I've always been kind of interested in these. It's sort of a top-down adventure roleplay thing, I believe. But again, I've never really played it. I would like to, though, so I'm happy to have a boxed copy here for the IBM PC. Another game that I've always been interested in is Heimdall, the really big adventures of Heimdall the Viking. Never played it, but this art has always intrigued me. There's kind of all this crazy perspective going on here, like these drawings. I don't really know what's going on, but I think it's fantastic. Yeah, living proof that the gods have a sense of humor. You know, it looks like it's full of personality. Top-down, scrolling, isometric, RPG attributes, whatever that means. I'm looking forward to trying this out at some point. It's a really cool-looking bit of box art, though. And speaking of just really cool packaging, check this out. This is the just Omnitrend's universe. Now, it's a space simulation kind of thing, but this packaging is phenomenal. Not only is it a really old, early PC game for MS-DOS 2.0, it comes in this package that reminds me of something like, almost like a spreadsheet, you know, or some sort of office software. It comes with all these little tabs here. It's very nicely put together. This is just like the geekiest thing I have ever seen. I think this is so cool. And it comes with these, what appear to be, I don't know if it actually came with it, but these are like addendum things to show some more information about, I guess, your ships and its capabilities. And there's even some handwritten notes right here too. This is fantastic. I don't know if it was Jackson's dad, but whoever had this and was playing this back in the day was absolutely into it. These kind of notes, that's hardcore. Plus just this binder, I mean, that's so cool. Wow. That's quality right there. Here's one that I am familiar with, although I haven't played this version. This is the enhanced CD-ROM edition of the original Lords of the Realm. Now, I've played the original one a little bit, the floppy disk one. But this one has professional BBC radio actors and a map and scenario for stuff and some animations and whatnot. I don't know. Seems pretty awesome. I've played Lord of the Realms 2 even more, the one that was published by Sierra, and I really like that one a lot. So I would like to dive into this one with the extra features and absolutely want to review this at some point. I mean, I want to review every single one of these, but this one in particular, it's been on my mind ever since I was a kid when I first played the Lords of the Realms games, and I just think it's super neat. I love medieval kind of kingdom strategy stuff. Here's another one that I've never played, but, you know, I've always heard of it, and I've always thought this box art's pretty sweet. You got the generic-looking barbarian dude, but, you know, it's just that whole possibility of an open landscape of just fantasy adventures in front of you, and it's by Origin, so there's got to be something to it, right? I would hope so. This is from, like, classic old-school Origin, and I think that is fantastic. I don't know what's inside here, but, well, I guess that's a map. Yeah, sometimes Origin had some super cool things packed in with their games. I gotta know if this is a map. because it really does feel like one. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's cool. Look at this. Look at that. It's paper. It's not cloth, so it could be a little more high quality. But, you know, whatever. This isn't an Ultima game. It's Times of Lore, so I will take what I can get. That is a super cool box and game to have, nonetheless. So is this, Spirit of Excalibur. I have only barely messed around with this one, like, way back in my sort of, I'll just play anything if it's on the PC kind of days. Mostly when I was downloading random abandonware from French websites in the early 2000s, but I remember it being kind of cool. It kind of gave me that idea of almost fairy tale adventure mixed with, like, you know, I don't know. It's been a long time since I played it. It almost gave me a sort of Defender of the Crown-esque thing. I don't know, but with more fantasy elements. Yeah, it seemed pretty cool. So I'd like to give it more of a playthrough sometime. Now here's one that, this is just a cool game to have, period. So, of course, we've got to have Discworld in any PC gamer's collection. This is one that's just eluded me for a long time. Well, actually, I did find a copy, but I gave it over to Pushing Up Roses because it was more of her thing. But, you know, finally I have my own copy here. And, of course, this is Terry Pratchett, so this game is hilarious. Insanely hard as far as the puzzles, nonsensical logic, and just, I mean, it is a tough game. But, man, is it funny. And this box art is, wow. That box art is just amazing. And of course, it is based on the series of novels by Mr. Pratchett. Rest in peace, by the way. And here's the last one of this box. Spellcraft, Aspects of Valor. Apparently distributed by Broderbund and I guess developed by ASCIIware. I had never heard of this. But again, you know, RPG-ish fantasy adventure something or other. I just see these screenshots and I'm like, okay, I want to play that. That looks cool. You got Stonehenge-ish kind of things going on here. You got dragons and, like, you know, sexy RPG ladies or something. I am all for that kind of stuff. And just spellcraft. Something, anything craft. I mean, I guess I'm interested in it. I don't know why. But yeah, we're going to go ahead and dive into the box that I have not opened fully yet at all. I've just taken off the tape and the address labels and stuff, and that's about it. Oh yes, I already see some familiar stuff in here. Right away, of course. We've got Zork 3. Just gonna glue that label back on there. Which is the third part of the original Zork trilogy, which was like a mainframe game way back in the day, text adventure. And it was split up into three games for the computers of the day. And I guess this is some maps, probably? Oh, yeah. Wow, these are very well done, too. I love that writing. Check that out. That'll get you into the mood to play this. I love finding things like this in old games. You know, I've actually never played Zork Part 3. I've played the first one a lot. I played the second one a bit on the Apple II, but I've never actually played the third one, so... Ooh, be careful with that sticker. Try to put that back together. Yeah, that's really cool to have. Did not own it until now. This one I do actually have on the Amiga, but I wanted to compare to the IBM PC version whenever I do get around to covering it. And this is the one and only Defender of the Crown by the one and only CinemaWare. This is when they were in full force in their interactive movie stage. And I mean, you know, just popcorn and everything. These games that they did back then were fantastic, I think. And this one in particular, I mean, it really was like a very cinematic style of experience. I always am amused by that guy with his, like, wedgie going on right there. I don't know. That just... It's on the back of a lot of CinemaWare boxes, and it just always distracts me for some reason. But anyway, it was a really cool game, and I'm definitely going to cover it, but mostly the Amiga version because, I mean... This one had award-winning graphics, maybe, but the Amiga one was, like, breathtakingly different as far as, just, like, nothing else out there at the time that it released. And here is just, oh, what a cool classic game here. We have The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. Of course, based on the classic book, novel, what have you. by Douglas Adams, sci-fi author extraordinaire. And yes, it comes with the microscopic space fleet and all sorts of other things in there. That's really just an empty plastic bag. Lots of gags. There's the don't panic glasses, which sunglasses, which literally just block your entire vision out. I love the extras that this comes with. And I mean, really just the game itself too is a lot of fun to go through. Even though, again, it's just text adventure. So not a whole lot to look at, but it's all in your mind. Here's one that I had never, ever heard of. And I love that art. It's like not the greatest necessarily, but it's so cheesy. And that cheesy logo, the point of no return subtitle. Oh. And, you know, New World Computing. So the Might and Magic people, maybe there's something cool to behold here. I don't know. It looks pretty ambitious. Adventure into a living universe. Discover, create, challenge, customize, solve, and enjoy. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm going to enjoy that whenever I get around to it. Or at least I hope so. I really like open-ended, you know, universe sims, space games, whatever. That's just neat. I like that a lot. There's another one that, there's a lot in this box that I had never heard of. Dragon World. Price Reeves, maybe they're the authors, I'm not sure. Yeah, one of several games that came in these boxes from MicroStation from back in the day. Adventure game software for the IBM PC and DOS and whatnot. It's got an ISBN number like a book. So that's... Oh, wow. Holy crap, this is super cool. Look at that. That is awesome. And it looks like everything is just sort of packed in here. Yeah. Ooh, there's a lot in there, too. Including, what is this? Oh, it's like an overlay. Apply to dampened window. Can be removed and reused. Oh, that's super cool. That's super cool. So you, like, make your own window in your room stained glass looking while you're playing through this game. Oh, that is awesome. Wow. Oh, it's based on a novel, so that makes sense why it has the sort of ISBN and, you know, author's names there. It doesn't look like a terribly much to look at, but, you know, that's why they included so many of those extras like that in a lot of games, because, you know, it adds to the experience, even if the graphics themselves may not be the most insane. This is cool. So this is Mind Wheel, an electronic novel by Synapse and Broderbund. I have heard about this one, and so when I saw that Jackson had this as an option of, like, something he would be willing to send, I'm like, oh my god. So this is, I mean, straight up, it is a novel, right? Like, there is a novel in here, but it is also a computer game of sorts. I've always wanted to just see how this comes together, and, yeah. You enter the world of Mind Wheel by typing on your computer keyboard. Type whatever text appears in it. Nah, sounds like a text adventure. Interactive fiction, though, in the most, like, literal sense. Because you actually have fiction here in your hand, a book. You can interact with it. That is such a cool thing to me. Oh, man, this is awesome. This is so awesome. I only have, like, one other game that comes in a book form. Maybe two others, so I don't see those very, very frequently. And here's a classic by Interplay. Got Dragon Wars here, and this is one that I have just always thought, holy crap, look at that art. Look at that art! Oh, heavy metal album cover, cheesy. It's just, that's pretty fantastic. So, yes, you have a sort of Bard's Tale-esque thing here. And, you know, I don't know what else to really say about it because I haven't spent any time with it. Although, if it's anything like the Bard's Tale, it's going to be pretty sweet. In fact, it supports the characters from Bard's Tale 1, 2, and 3 right there. So, yeah, just keep your story going here in Dragon Wars. That'll be neat. I'd like to do a full playthrough of the Bard's Tale things, keep the save game going, and maybe put them over to Dragon Wars. That'd just be kind of a neat video project, I think. Here's another Koei game, Bandit Kings of Ancient China. Just more fantastic box art. And it's a Koei, you know, simulation, war thing, strategy-ish, whatever. I don't know. It's a Koei game. If you've played a couple of their early ones, you've played them all, basically. But I think they're really fantastic. And this comes in one of these really nice clamshell cases that you see with a lot of games that were from, you know, Japan and China and whatnot at the time. And I'm kind of surprised to see this one got this treatment here in what is presumably an American release, because as you saw, that Genghis Khan one, it hasn't held up so well. But this one, I mean, this is like pretty much, you know, looking how it did the day it was new. Yeah, those kind of cases are just really sweet. Yet another SSI game I had never heard of. And, you know, I know it seems like, oh man, you don't know anything about games. But, you know, it's just this whole era of 80s computer games. I missed out on this completely as a youngster. And this is why I really want to get into some of this stuff. Because, wow, not only are they pretty hard to find sometimes, but, I mean, they just look super intriguing. And obviously, you know, the purchaser of these games were into a certain style, because there's a lot of similar looking stuff here. But yeah, I'm not sure what I think about that box art. That's kind of dumb, to be honest. I like the bottom half of this. You know, that's kind of cool. But that guy just looks like a doofus. Oh, well. Oh, here we go. Another SSI game, Wizard's Crown. I have at least heard of this one, but again, I've never played it. Really colorful box art, though, like the trolls and, you know, stuff that's going on here. I guess that's sort of a cyclops. Anyway, look at this. They put as much color as possible onto the back of the box, because there's not a whole lot of color going on in-game, it looks like. Maybe some green and yellow, so let's just make the back of the box green and yellow as well. Yeah. I'm curious what's inside of this one. It feels like it's got some stuff. All right. Oops. We got a manual, some other things, and discs. Not a whole lot. Still, though, really sweet. Always like to add more SSI games to the collection. The boxes hold up quite well, too. Speaking of boxes holding up well, here's a game by Rainbird, Night One. So it has Loosed Orc, A Kind of Magic, Hordes of the Mountain King. So it's a trilogy of fantasy adventure games. And supposedly a humorous tale of revenge. I was not familiar with this. I do like some of the other... I like any Rainbird release because of these blue boxes. They just look really nice. And this one in particular is just one I was not familiar with at all. And it says it was made in the UK, published in the USA by Firebird. Sweet. Just wondering what it has in here. Oh, yeah. It does have the blue... there's always blue manuals, blue labels on the discs, all that kind of stuff. My camera is not focusing because it's a jerk. But, yeah, look at this. There's some cool stuff in there. Cool stuff everywhere. I'm going to take a look at this because it's been hanging around in the background for a little bit. This is a game called Wilderness, a survival adventure. Another one of those that is pretty tough to come by in my experience. I looked for it casually in the past, just because I'm always intrigued by survival games. And this is quite an early one. Oh, wow. Got a travel pass here. What is this? Get yourself another piece of the world. Whoa! So you could, like, order other countries to explore? This is pretty freaking ambitious. And again, it's in, like, a book format. I did not know that it was. Oh, man. This is something that I would like to play with my dad. I really should. He is a survival, like, I don't want to say freak, but kind of is. I mean, he's all about that stuff. I mean, he will go out and just hike forever if you let him. And, I mean, this is the kind of stuff that he is absolutely into. I'd kind of be curious to sort of have him playing along with me sometime and be like, hey, let's see if we can figure this out. I'm not sure how well it plays or holds up, but... this has me absolutely fascinated just because of the survival aspect of it. I think that's really cool. And a generic Mick Adventure guy on the front here, which, all right, why not? Wow. Another Koei game. This is cool to have, and I'm glad it comes in this really nice case like the other one did. So not just Bandit Kings came in this case, but apparently Romance of the Three Kingdoms 2 did as well. Yes. Oh my. That is quite a beefy manual. This is so cool.
Oh, that is a cool freaking poster. Holy crap. Oh, that's awesome. Oh.
Here we go. Now this. Holy crap. This is Ancient Land of Ease. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. That's how I've kind of heard it before. This is a Falcom game, which was most popular on a bunch of Japanese computers, but it did indeed get an American localized release by Broderbund. And, I mean, check it out. This is super freaking awesome. I have looked for this for a long time and never, ever seen a copy, except for one that was sealed that went for, like, way too much money. Of course, that was sealed, so I don't even know what the normal box one comes, you know, goes for, but wow, that's cool. I've always liked this original artwork, too, for their first Ease game. I'd like to find some of the others as well, but even just that one is just fantastic to have. Oh, shame this one is in such a crushed up box. I might be able to get that in better shape. Anyway, this is The Black Cauldron, a adventure game based on the Disney movie, and it's very much like King's Quest, made by the same people, some of the same designers, and Sierra, of course. But, you know, it's The Black Cauldron, except it's an animated adventure game, and it's not particularly great. But it is one of those earlier ones of theirs where it lets you go around and use the arrow keys or a joystick to move. And, you know, I mean, it was a thing for a while, right? It's like, oh, you don't have to use the parser for absolutely everything. You can just, you know, move in directions. I did not know it came with this, though. That's wow. Now, I am in awe of stuff like this. Look at that. That's so cool. Hopefully I can get that box to sort of come back together because it's kind of falling apart. This is one that I have never heard of. I Damiano, the Wizard of Partestrada. That is the nerdiest thing I've heard in a long time, and I love it. I love it, love it, love it. By Bantam Imagic, Living Literature. Yes, it's another one of those that folds out into something amazing. Oh, look at that. Look at that. This stuff will never cease to just... Oh, look at that. Look at this. This is so cool. Does that come up? It doesn't even look like it's been opened. What the heck? Okay, that is fantastic. Again, box is kind of smushed up. I don't know from the shipping or what, but... This has got to be somewhat uncommon. I don't really know. 1985. That's awesome. Here we go. Early game by Paragon and distributed by EA. I did not know that. But apparently this one was. This is Alien Fires, 2199 AD. I'm most familiar with Paragon, and you probably are too, if you're into DOS games, for their superhero games. You know, they did Spider-Man, X-Men... all bunch of other stuff, Punisher and whatnot. Really early games for Marvel, but they also did, you know, this and I don't know, a bunch of other things. This, on the other hand, I'd never heard of it. I mean, I had heard of it, but I'd never actually seen it, the box or anything. So, Alien Fires. Most certainly never have played it. Kind of neat box art, though, isn't it? I mean, it looks a little amateurish, but then again, I don't really care. Alien things like that can get away with a lot, in my opinion. So even if you've got like a goofy bull bear thing with the robot something, I'm on board. I am on board with whatever is in store with that game. Here we go. This is super cool. So this is The Holy Grail. A time quest adventure. And no, this is not Monty Python. This is just The Holy Grail, as far as I know, because, I mean, I have the Monty Python Holy Grail game as well for PC, but this one is just interactive fiction that happens to be based on, I guess, the sort of overall lore. I don't know, but, oh, again, oh my goodness, look at this. Wow. This reminds me of the manual of, The Elder Scrolls Arena. It's got that same sort of fantastic texture that just lets you know you're playing a fantasy game. You should feel this. It feels so good. More wonderful handwritten notes in that fantastic handwriting. Oh, that's so cool. Nice red disc, too. Look at that. I don't see too many retail games coming on colored floppy disks outside of, like, Japan. So that's a welcome thing. It's rated G. This is like a movie. Yeah, it's a movie, see? Maybe this was a movie. But I don't think so. I've never heard of it. Starring you. I don't know. Directed by Ken Smith. I'm going to have to look up more about this because, I don't know. All I knew was what it was a Holy Grail thing, and it was not Monty Python. So I was intrigued. Ah, here we go. Ultima 3 Exodus in the original box. Now, I already had this in trilogy form. They had the first three Ultima games that came in a trilogy, one single box, but didn't have this one. And look at that. Just look at it. Oh, this makes me really happy. No screenshots in the back, which is kind of typical for these. But man, let's see what it comes with inside. It's Ultima. It's Ultima, man. That's cool. It does have the cloth map. Oh, it does. Oh, this is what I was hoping for. There it is. Look at this. Somebody's even put like pins in it and stuff to mark their locations. Wow. Yeah, look at those, like those pins. There's red pins. There's a yellow, a couple white maybe. There's a blue one down there. This is the coolest. Ultima, early Ultima games had some of the most fantastic extras like that, and yeah, they sort of cheapened out on them for the trilogy releases, which is one reason I was wanting to get this, but also just because of the box. I mean, that box, I think, is fantastic. It you might think it's cheesy, and it is, but it's the best kind. And then last, but absolutely not least, we have Station Fall, the sequel to Planet Fall. Yeah. This one opens up in this kind of a thing here instead of one with the front flap. Oh, yeah. This is just... that's fantastic. Looks like it holds up pretty darn well, too. This is all the way on the bottom. It's not even really smashed up much at all. And I love this, too. Like, they always had these really, like, classy-looking kind of images that were barely related to... you know, it's like, okay, here's kind of what you get in the box, but... you know, it's just a text game, so you're not going to be seeing, like, you know, just look pictures of text. That's awesome. That's just, it's really cool art, too. Ah, wow. Okay, so that is a lot of games, and that is a lot of really cool stuff. So, I don't even know where I'm going to begin as far as archiving this stuff, doing videos on it. All I know is I want to cover, like, all of it, really, because... I mean, this is great. This is amazing. One of the single most amazing hauls I have ever had. I mean, ever. So again, Sir Jackson, I feel like calling you sir. This is just amazing, okay? What? So yes, that's all I gotta say. Thank you very much for watching.